Hey everybody, in this video I'm going to share with you three things you can do when unexpected bad stuff happens in your life. Got a lot of students who are trying to watch this to improve their performance in school and just their overall life success even after school. And so we're going to be applying those principles to these students. The first tip really revolves around life events. Here's the thing, successful people know that negative life events happen to everyone. And so when that happens, they're not shocked, they're not reactive, they have prepared for it, they know it's gonna happen at some point, and they have processes to deal with this and put their best foot forward and succeed. You know, when you're in school, there's tons of crap that can happen. In a previous video, I told a story about a sanitation worker who had to work before school to help pay for his dad who had cancer. And very recently he got into Harvard Law. But that was a very tough time for him. And he took out garbage and he did poorly in school. And his outlet at the time was martial arts. He figured that was how he was gonna succeed. But a couple injuries here and there just took him out of it. Now did it let him slow him down? No. He continued at it, he tried his best, and then he got into a college and transferred into University of Maryland. When more negative life events happened and his dad's condition got worse, did he just quit and let it crumble him and just give up on life? No, he actually ended up taking a couple years off school and college, resuming his work as a sanitation worker, helping his dad get back on his feet with his medical bills, and then go back to school. And look at him now, you know, he's in Harvard Law. He, you know, even if he chooses not to go to law school, he has all that credibility behind him with that brand, that great story. He's gonna do fine, and it's so inspiring. Now, I don't expect you to just off the gate be like that. I wasn't. You know, there's definitely moments in school where I just crumbled because life events and stuff got really hard and I just gave up on everything. But pick yourself back up, realize that life is long. You might have another 60, 70, 80 years ahead of you. So there's always time to turn things around. And although it took me a couple years or two to really have that hope again, I did. And that brings me to tip number two. Tip number two is to have some level of support network. Sometimes some people can't get it from home because of their family. Others have other negative life events that cause them to have issues, maybe even at school making friends, bullies and stuff like that. So where do you get a support network? How do you actually improve there? Now this is difficult, but I found that one friend who was just naturally very positive and very good at school. And at the time I just kind of gravitated to him because, you know, he was a friendly guy. You know, one of the friendly people who was treating me as an equal with respect. And then over time, all of a sudden, before I even knew it, I was doing better in school and I realized his tactics were rubbing off on me. He was always talking about studying after school and how excited he was to do better on this test. And I couldn't help but, you know, try out a little bit of that myself. So, you know, you may not have that one friend. You could have searched the whole school, but there's always someone. Maybe it's this video. Maybe it's my podcast. Maybe it's not me. Maybe it's one of those other YouTubers or some Facebook group. Maybe it's not online. Maybe it's some type of support system or study group that you found. Maybe other students in other activities. You can find support groups in some of the strangest places. Going back to that inspiring story of a man who, in many ways, you know, did better than me in certain aspects, he found it through his other fellow sanitation workers. You know, it was the first time where, and based on the article I read, it was the first time where people supported him and people encouraged him and told him he was smart and that he could do it. And that's incredible, you know, that's incredible that they would come up and say that. And it can come from anywhere. It doesn't mean that they have to be successful or good at school for you to have that in this guy's case. And then the third tip is always just hope and perseverance. You know, this guy clearly had some very tough times throughout his school years where he had some very poor grades. And most would assume, you know, if you have poor grades, you're going to continue having it. People assume that you're just never going to be smart if you're not smart now. But turns out, you know, he held on, he had that hope, and he said once he got into college, University of Maryland, all of a sudden, he had all this support all these support systems that he never had. There was breakout study groups, there was teachers helping him, thousands of classmates, and all of a sudden, he couldn't help but to do good. Everyone was supporting him on his journey. So it may not happen this year or next year or in a few years, but incredible story about how this guy turned around his grades and his life. And, you know, I'm not expecting you to be as perfect as this guy or even as close, because, you know, I certainly was. And I'm not beating myself up either. There's stuff that I did better than he did and vice versa. But, you know, the third thing is just about that perseverance and hope. Just because things aren't going well now doesn't mean that they'll always go bad. You know, time always moves forward, and some things are bound to happen. You know, people die, crap happens to you. But, you know, every day you still have your healthy brain intact and you have food on the table. I mean, that's all you can really hope for. And that gratitude and those limited expectations out of life can really just give you that winner's attitude. So you're not blaming, you're not complaining, you're putting your best step forward and making the most of those times. Trust me, it's tough. It is really tough. I've been there, but hopefully this will help you out. Thanks for watching. Subscribe. I'll see you later.